Welcome back to the Republic of Lewis. I'm Louie Lewis, as I said before that song, and Dave Barneville is with me.
Still here.
Now, we have an amazing interview for you today. We're joined by Shane O'Fergal from the band Crusoe. Shane, how are you getting on?
Good. How's it going?
I am good. I'm so much happy that you are here because I've been a fan of you guys for a good while. For anyone who hasn't heard of you, let's just bring it back. The band was first put together...
Yeah, about 4 years ago in Dublin.
Mm-hmm. And what does it consist of? I know it's you. Is it another person?
Yeah,
as well?
It's kind of a funny one. It's a band that consists of whatever the gig is. You know, it's five or six, seven or eight people, depending on the gig.
It's kind of like Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds.
Well, maybe.
Yeah, but like a changing, touring kind of band members.
Yeah, we've got a plethora of musicians to draw from.
That's brilliant. That's what you want. I think that's what makes a good band, because it's always fresh people coming in. Then
it kind of mixes it up a bit. Yeah. Then.
Well, I'm a big believer in live music, and I like to change the dynamic every time we play, so you don't get bored. There's always, as you say, new blood coming in, and there's new energies on stage. You know, it keeps it fresh for the musicians.
Now, I must ask, the name Crusoe, it's a great name, but it's an unusual name. It's a name that you'll always remember. But where did that name come from?
Do you want the freaky story, or do you want the kind of the PR stunt story?
Tell the two of them.
Well, the freaky story is I had a dream, and it was to be Crusoe. That was it. And it was in a shower. So it was pretty weird. It was an epiphany.
When you said a dream there, I think it was John Lennon. His story where the name The Beatles came from.
Yeah, really?
I think he'd said now. Of course, it was a lie that he had a dream of the name Beatles on a flaming pie.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's the first thing that popped in my head. I was like, this is a John Lennon story.
Yeah, no, that's the true story.
All right.
I had an epiphany, and I like to tell people she was Italian, but, you know. No, the name is comes from an Italian surname, but the famous Enrico Caruso. He was a brilliant, one of the first opera singers to put vocals to vinyl. Oh. So I thought that was quite cool. But that's where the name came from, and it's been a blessing for me and for the band in Europe.
Mm-hmm. Now you are actually you're at a turn at the moment, aren't you? I think tomorrow for Arthur's Day, are you playing a gig?
We're doing a gig in town for Arthur's Day. Yeah, and I can't give away the. I nearly gave away the guest, the surprise star, but I can't tell you who it is.
You can tell us where it is, though, can't you?
It's Fordame Lane, yeah.
Fordame Lane.
And the venue has been selected as one of the headlining acts. So
it's going to be someone big, would you?
Yeah. They're not that big now. They're not tall.
Yeah.
But they're small. That might give you a hint.
I can't think.
You can still get tickets for that.
You can't. They don't sell tickets. It's thrown up on the door moment.
And that's going to start at what time?
5 o'clock.
Is it? Yeah. Are they doing the Guinness time where a gig starts, or is it? Or anything
stupid
like that?
1759, the toast.
Is that what it is? Oh, wow, because funnily enough, I'm on at 5 o'clock, so I'll be doing a half an hour slot, so I'll probably come right up to the end of that. And then Caruso are playing at 8 o'clock, so I have two slots tomorrow.
Oh, that is good.
So yeah,
different songs though.
Of course.
Yeah. It won't be just the
no,
full band now. Like.
I get to indulge myself with folky stuff first, and then we hit the alternative rock and roll moment.
Are they all your originals, are they?
Or they will be, yeah.
Cool. So your whole fan base will be there anyway?
Well, I don't know. We've had requests for 80 spaces, but we can't. We're only allowed to have 20 guest list for Caruso, so it's whoever turns up again.
Yeah.
It's one of those things. It's great. I mean, we don't have to worry about the guest list or people. Cool.
And of course, your song, it was a few months back you released the single Freak.
Freak, yeah.
Was that a different radio station had it as their single of the week?
Yeah, it was, I think it was 2FM.
We won't talk about the other radio. We won't talk about the other radio station.
We don't know who they were, but they were a really big broadband width thing.
It was like an Irish, national Irish station.
One of those.
It was like a second
them.
National Irish kind of station,
yeah,
but we won't say the name.
With a two in it.
Yeah, and there was an FM as well. Somewhere in the name.
Thank God.
No. If that is, it is an amazing song. Is that what you're going to play later for us?
I'm not, no.
No? Oh, is it a new song?
It's a new song, yeah.
Oh, have you?
It's off the new album.
Oh,
is it? That's okay.
Yeah, of course. Well, I love all your stuff. Is it a new, is it like exclusive?
It could be, actually.
You know, we love exclusives.
It could be an exclusive, yeah. I've never played this on radio before, so yeah, it could be.
So it could be. Yesterday we gave you the exclusive of the first European Donovan interview since he was brought into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And the day before that, we had the first single
from Late City Edition.
Late City Edition, I think 4 months before it's going to get its proper airplay. So what's the name of the song you're going to play?
The song is called You Get What You Paid For.
Oh, I like that. I like that name.
Mm.
And right, we must mention your website. What is your website?
It's www.caruso.ie.
And you have a Facebook page as well.
We do, and it's just Caruso Ireland. But you'll get all those details on the website if you go. Sure.
We'll actually put a link there. So, do you want to go into the song now, or would you like to talk about anything else?
Do you want me to play it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd love to, yeah.
Well, that's great. Well, you just tune up and get your guitar ready. We'll just talk over. But this is possibly, maybe, an exclusive.
It's an exclusive key.
An exclusive. There we go. There we go. Okay, let's have it then.
Okay. Look how they carry me, uh-oh. Look how they teach us to be so positive. Look how they teach us to feel. Just look at us now. Look at us now. We're real. Doesn't matter what they want you to feel. Stand up and go all out. One look, yeah, you might find you get what you get what you paid for. Look how they fold our smiles. Look how they teach us to be so innocent. Look how they teach us to leave with our hands to the skies, down on our knees. It's real. A million wonders in a world you change. Stand up. Things will stay the same with one look. Yeah, you might find you get what you came through broken windows and you still play games. Shut up and go all out. One look. Yeah, you might find you get what you look nice. It's just you. And now we're standing on the back foot. Now everything's so different. I know what's on your mind. Yeah, we're all living for the weekends. And it's all so difficult. But look at how they shine. They're coming in at high speed as they come crashing around your ears. Crashing around your ears. Crashing around. A million wonders in a world you change. Stand up or things will stay the same. With one look, yeah, you might find you get what you get what you came through broken windows and you still play games. You shut up and go all out. One look, yeah, you might find you get what you get what you paid for. Paid for. Paid for. You look nice. It's just right. It's okay. You got wise.
Woo-hoo! That was great. That's called You Get What You Pay For.
Get What You Paid For.
And when's that out?
Well, it's going to be on the new album, which is due to be released in January.
January.
It's a US release, but it's going to be flying into Europe after that.
But you'll be able to get it on iTunes.
You will.
Straight away.
Absolutely.
Does the album have a name yet?
It does. It's called Everything You Need Is Here.
Excellent.
That is a good name. Now, we mentioned that you're playing tomorrow. Is there any other tour dates coming up?
Not at the moment, no.
Nothing's penciled in, yeah.
Nothing. I'm taking a break for a month because I have to get this album boxed off, artwork and all that. And I've been around Europe for the last 4 months and I'm absolutely exhausted.
Yeah, because I think last time I heard from you, you're in Poland. Yeah. You do is it a European kind of writing thing that you do?
That's right, yeah. We just had a week of that up in Donard in West Wicklow and it finished on Sunday. So that's pretty intense. I just got back from a 3-week tour of Hungary, Italy, Austria and Slovenia, and then straight back into that writing thing for a week. So I'm a little worn out.
And how did that writing thing come about though? Like,
From doing gigs in Innsbruck, I met up with a few people over there in Austria, and they love the stuff. They're kind of fans of the music, mm-hmm. So they put me forward for it because it was an Austrian based incentive, and that kind of kicked into other things. And we met. There was a group of, I think, 14, 15 countries at one stage, and now it's whittled down to 8 and we keep it going. So we've met in 8 countries so far, and we do it probably 2-3 times a year.
Jeez, that sounds brilliant. Now, you're a big fan of like the Irish language, aren't you?
Yeah.
I think on your website that you have is it sections of the words and all in Irish?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, what was the idea about that? Like, is it just because you're a big fan of Irish?
Yeah, well, I come from an English-speaking background, and mm-hmm. I'm very proud to be Irish, so I just try and promote it where I can, and yeah. I'm learning myself all the time. I wouldn't be fluent now by any means, but I'm getting there, you know.
Yeah,
so it's just to do me a bit.
Would you perform any of the songs?
I do. I've 3 or 4 songs Oscarilla, yeah. And Tommy Scrieve Oscarilla, yeah. First, you know.
See, that just goes over my head because I think Irish, the way it's taught in Ireland, I think it's just wrong. It's kind of forced on you. In primary school, but that's for another show.
That's a completely different show.
Yeah, it's for another show completely. But it means that I can't watch. What's that? Tina G. What's the soap opera? What's the soap opera that's on?
Ross and the Ruin. Yeah.
And I want to watch it because it's meant to be brilliant.
But subtitles, isn't it?
Oh, that means I need to concentrate on the bottom of the screen, and then I'm losing facial reactions, and we are getting off topic as usual. But listen, Shane, I want to thank you for coming in, and that was a great song. Once again, it can go to the website, which is crusoe.ie.
Yeah,
and every other link will be found from there. Now later on we will put on our little page a link to that. But thanks for coming in.
Appreciate it.
We're gonna go to a bit of this stunning